Hi YouTube! So this video today is another video about Aspergers, because I've decided to do another one. I found out that I had Aspergers when I was 13. Specifically remember because I was playing Roller Coaster Tycoon at the time. Don't ask me why I remember that, but I have this insane memory. Like, that's one of the things with Aspergers, that you have this memory. Like, sometimes it's dates or even, like, car registration plates or something like that. For me, it's dates. Like, I can look at a picture, right? And I'll be able to tell you, like, the date that it was taken. So, there we go. Like, it freaks people out sometimes, but I know, because particularly like from pictures, like, because I can remember the day when it was taken, and I can remember it's hard to try and explain why, but I can. Not just any random picture, I mean like pictures like from my childhood and stuff. Most of them I can't will be able to tell you what the date was. Another thing, so that's one thing, but now I'm going back. So this is my little story now. So basically when I was young, like when I was a child, you know, I was just like any other normal, because I hate the word normal, child of that age. You know, I went to nursery, or kindergarten, I think, as you could call it in the US. I went to a normal primary school and everything, so. Yeah. So when I was in primary three, my teacher noticed that I was different, you know, like, I had, you know, there was different things that, basically, like, I was quite quiet, like, I didn't really interact much with the other children in the class. Like, in all my school reports, it was like, Rachel doesn't communicate with her peers, meaning other children in the class, or I remember one report said something like Rachel needs to learn how to tie her shoelaces, and in my opinion those things are important. Well, they are important, but the thing was, when I was in primary school I tried my bloody best, I really did, but a lot of the time the teachers just didn't see that, and I think that perhaps maybe some of them thought that I was stupid or wouldn't amount to anything. But I always tried my hardest, I really really did. And yeah, I remember primary three, so I was six, and the teacher I had, as I was mentioning before, she didn't understand me, like she got frustrated, and because I hadn't been diagnosed with anything yet, like she didn't know how to deal with me. Like sometimes, like I remember one time I was sitting in the class, and so our classroom was here, and then when you looked out the window you saw a playing field which we used for sports days and things. And I remember there specifically being like a black dog, it was in the playing field, and I shouted out in the class and I went, "Hey look, there's a dog outside," and I was excited. I was excited obviously, because you don't normally see dogs in the playing field, do you? So, and she went like this, I remember she went, "Who said that?" And then when she found out it was me, she was like, "How dare you?" And yeah, I remember, like, well, I don't remember that well, but I think that I was actually probably quite scared. And yeah, most of my teachers in primary school were pretty nice, but I know they did get frustrated with me at times. When I got to primary five, so I was about this point 8, 9, I used to go to this place and I would see this woman and she would help me with, like, coordination thing. So she taught, like, how to throw and catch a ball, because, like, in PE and stuff, like, I was, like, even when I got to high school still, I was, like, I would get, like, team games or whatever. I'm not a very competitive person anyway, but in team games, like, I'd just stand there and I'd be like, woo, and yeah. Like, here's an example. This was when I was in second year of high school, and basically I remember we were playing basketball and we had to go into partners, and I was put with this guy that I didn't really like. He was horrible to me, and I got put with him and he wasn't passing the ball to me at all. And I remember saying to him that you're supposed to pass the ball to me. But anyway, basically in the end, I ended up, he threw the ball to me and I got winded with the ball and I had to sit out. So that's another thing. My coordination is zero, like, and my spatial awareness as well. So, like, when I'm walking down the street, sometimes I have no concept of where I'm actually walking. And that's how sometimes, like, you know how sometimes when you're walking down the street and somebody will, and you go, oh, and somebody will be walking and then you try to walk and then they try to walk and then it's like, oh, sorry, and then that, you know, that awkward kind of, that happens to me quite a lot. And, like, I'll bump into things and I'll fall, and I actually slip when I was walking down the road because my house is on top of a hill, so yep. And it was snowy. So coordination isn't very good. It's also because of that reason. Coordination, spatial awareness, it's also because that's the reason why I don't want to learn to drive a car. But it doesn't really bother me that much. Well, it does. It was something I would like to be able to do, but I don't actually think that I could. Maybe one day, but I can get the bus and everything. I'm pretty independent, so I can get the trains, I can get the buses up the trains. I get the train into Glasgow and I get the bus to college and I go down and I go shopping myself. So I'm pretty independent. But what I wanted to make this video to show that Asperger's, it's not a bad thing. Me, I've only got it. Like, I've only got it a little bit, like this much. Like, on the scale, there's like an autistic scale, it's like 0 to 10, and I am like 0.1 on that scale. So it doesn't affect me that much, but there are some people, like, that don't have Asperger's but have actual autism, and, like, that some people, like, they can't speak or whatever, and they actually are, like, I don't mean this in a bad way or anything, but they are actually, like, noticeably autistic, but from looking at me you wouldn't know there was anything there, you know. It doesn't really bother me, and to be honest, you know, most of the time I just forget that it's even there. It's part of who I am, and yeah, well, without it, I wouldn't be Rachel, would I?